Back for more, I see. Well, now that we've got everything wired up, we've got a little more hardware set up to do before anything will work. We touched on this topic earlier in this course, but we're going to have to dive a little deeper into how DMX channel and address mapping works so that we can set everything up properly. Just to refresh, remember that a DMX universe contains 512 channels, each with a value between 0 and 100%. When you want to add a DMX fixture to your lighting system, you need to figure out how many DMX channels it requires, and also the function of each channel. The best way I can think of to learn this concept is by example. So check out this sweet RGB fixture I purchased on Amazon. Here's what came inside the box. See that tiny white paper thing? It's usually mistaken for junk mail, garbage, toilet paper, or sometimes a fire starter, but actually it's a very important document known as a user's manual. That sounds pretty important, so let's take a look, shall we? Jackpot! The user guide was kind enough to tell me that this handy little fixture requires 5 channels of DMX. Channels 2 through 5 each control the intensity of the individual colors within the fixture: red, green, blue, and white. For example, a value of 255 on channel 2 will turn on the red LEDs to maximum brightness. If we leave channel 2 at 100% and dial channel 4, blue, up to 100%, you'll have a nice bright purple. Pretty simple. Channel 1 functions as a master dimmer for all of the lights in the fixture. In other words, this value has a direct impact on the effect of the other 4 values, just like the master fader on an audio console. For example, if I leave channel 2 and channel 4 at 100% and then set channel 1 to 50%, the actual light output of the red and blue LEDs will be at 50% intensity. Now, let's assign the base address of this lighting fixture so that it knows which DMX channels to associate with these 5 values. Like many DMX devices, this one has a button menu interface. I can use this to set the DMX offset address, which is depicted as A and a number, where the number is the offset address. Here's what it looks like when I configure it for DMX channel 1. Here's how that configuration aligns with our DMX universe. Just for fun, let's say that I want to add a second light fixture of the exact same type. If I want both light fixtures to behave exactly the same, I could also set the new fixture's address to A1. However, if I want to control them independently, I would configure it for a different set of channels by setting it to an address value like A6. This lines it up nicely with our DMX channel map without interfering with our first fixture. With these two fixtures mapped to my DMX universe, I've used up 10 channels of DMX, leaving me with 502 more channels of freedom. Using these techniques, you can configure each of your DMX fixtures with addresses that use your freedom wisely. Just keep in mind that not all fixtures use the same number of channels, so be sure to read that user guide. Also, keep in mind that the address of DMX devices can be configured in many different ways. Basic devices may use dip switches or hex encoders like this. Other devices, like my Amazon Special, may use some kind of display with buttons or touch capability. Just know that whatever the method, these same key concepts always apply. Okay, all of your devices should now be wired up and configured, so we shouldn't have to mess with the hardware anymore. Unless, of course, you've been playing Animal Crossing instead of paying attention. Now, it's time to dig into the software side of things and bring our lights to life.